Welcome to another special edition of Mark's Tasty Tong. Happy New Year, everybody. That is indeed the first line of anything we should be saying today. Happy, happy New Year. Let's hope 2021 brings us much health, wealth, and happiness. Don't know much about the health part. Not this damn virus, but let's not even go there. Morning. Happy New Year. I'm going to switcheroo this camera around because I need to show you some nice beef. Let's do this. These are my silver sides for today. I'm only doing four, so I won't be boring you for too long. I have literally just taken out a really nice batch of drivors. Already sliced, ready to be bagged. That will be done either later today or tomorrow. Check it out. Drivors. Yummy. So what say we get this show on the road, shall we? I am gonna switch the camera around. I did get a new toy for Christmas. Not so much a toy, as much as it is a nice sharp, what? A nice sharp knife. Check this. Beautiful. Let me give us some light. Hold your pose. Hold your horses. Too many tubs lying here. Whoa. Here we go. He said, let there be light, and there was light. Here you thought I was just having a day off, eh? Well, I've had a few days off. Have another look at this knife. Look at that blade. Absolutely stunning. Beautiful, beautiful. It's called a Nigo. Sashimi knife. It's a sashimi. 8.5 inch. And we're about to test its sharpness. I'm gonna get some gloves on first. Hope you've all had a good Christmas. And I hope you were all social distancing last night. Of course you were. We had all of our friends on a party app. We managed to have a few drinks together online and see in the new year, which was pretty awesome because technology these days allows you to do such things. Now, I am going to move the phone slightly and I'm going to tilt. Hopefully, you can see. Of course you can. Let's leave this knife on the side. I'm going to start off with the really nicest of the roasts that I have. There's a couple of big ones and a couple of small ones, I think. So, let's do it. Who has a New Year's resolution? And if you do, what is it? Work harder, sleep longer. I would like this year to be the year of Mark's Tasty Tong. My contract in London as an engineer runs out in September, and I would like to do this full time, so that's my plan, and I'm going to stick to it. So let's start off with, we need a tub for the trimmings. Let's put that there. So, I haven't cut any meat for a few days. I've had a few days off, and now I won't be drinking for another few days. I wasn't quite nursing a hangover this morning. I was quite well behaved last night. But then again, I did have a bit of a headache, but that's what pills are for. I'm doing what I always tell you not to do, and that is slice towards yourself. They should not do such things. So we're literally taking that top layer off. This is going to be a very nice fatty roast. I do not intend in cutting all the fat off on the other side. You'll see why in a minute. Really nice yellow fat, beautiful and tasty. We shall be utilizing all of it. Right, I'm going to turn this around. You can see the silver strip there. Let's get rid of this bit of gunk on the side here. Just pull. That is literally this tendon, sinew. And I'm going to warn you now, if I sneeze, I won't sneeze on the meat. It's because I just mixed up some spices a little while ago and I couldn't stop sneezing. I had to actually exit the room. That is your sinew right there. And that all comes off. I don't know anybody that uses that unless it can be dried and used as a dog chew. That's about as good as I think it will be useful. I think even a dog would struggle to chew through that tendon. It's very tough. Tough and stringy. I have cut game biltong before, game meat back in Zim, and you do get a lot of sinews as well. Right, let's get this bottom round roast off. What we call the bottom round, what the Americans call the bottom round, I don't know. I still don't know what we call it. I should actually do a bit of research so I can give you some facts next time. Let's get rid of this bit of sinew up top here. I would like some lean off these as well because I need to make some chilli bites and some original bites. I do have biltong in stock if you want to order. I needed to get a little bit of meat the other day, so I just got a couple of boxes. Hence why we are now slicing on New Year's Day. So, let's get this. See here, this is just sinew as well. So, here's a little hint on what's up the top. Look at that. Don't worry about that bit of darkness there, that's just from blood. But look how yellow that fat is. That is the nicest one I've had in quite some time. Don't always get it. But let me tell you, it looks delish. When you order fatty this week, that's what you'll be getting. I do have some lean in for those of you who do not like the fat. So don't worry yourself. So all I'm doing on the side here is taking off some more sinew. And I'm going to trim this bit of fat off the edge here with some meat. It will still get dried. And it will still be delicious. Look at that. Absolutely beautiful. I am going to leave it back this way because I want to cut from the right to left. Your left to right. Let's go with a new knife. Oh man, that is beautiful. Cutting like a hot knife through butter. Just kind of lean into it. Look at that meat. This video will be uploaded to YouTube later. For those of you that missed the live session, or that would like to subscribe to my channel, please do so. Just search for Mark's Tasty Tong. This is absolutely beautiful. Look at this fat on there. Who wants that piece? Mr. Charlton, are you watching? I assume you are, or you will. Always does. He'd want that. He'd be on that like a rash. So, all I'm going to do now is just trim. I've obviously put it on its side. I'm just trimming the bottom to give myself a better platform. That gives me a bit of lean as well. Now, I've got a bit of... Oh, mama. That is beautiful. Now, obviously when you're cutting the big pieces, be very careful if you are doing this yourself. Very easy to go in at a wrong angle and end up cutting this hand. Especially when you get near the end. So always be aware where that blade is going. Oh man, that's going to be tasty, biltong. This is... I might actually keep this lot for myself. But that would be very selfish of me. And if you are just joining us, we're slicing up a bit of silverside for some tasty biltong. What better way to start the year for me than to slice up some beautiful beef. It's absolutely stunning. Look at the fat on this. That is absolutely stunning. They all go, this has got just the nicest amount of fat on there. I love that. Absolutely tasty, tasty, tasty. Right, we've got our bottom round now. I'm going to try and keep it sort of level just to trim the bottom off. Just giving myself better platform. You know the story. I like just having a flat base. What I will be doing with these pieces straight away is cutting thin strips. And this is for stokkies. That's your stokkies. But I've got a tub on the side that I will continue to add to. And I'm going to do this at the same time so that you can see how the stokkies are made as well. As soon as you've cut a slice, simply move it on into the tub. You don't want them too thin. Trust me, when that dries, it's half that size. Now, we got this beautiful yellow fat. Just look at that. Don't know if the camera's actually bringing it up. I'm sure it is. I'll have all and everybody that likes fat salivating over this piece. Do have some fatty in stock. It's not as fatty as this. It's not very often I get this nice fat. Obviously this is a little bit tough near the end because it's warmed up a little since I've started handling it. Yeah, some might say that's a little too much fat, but actually once that's sliced and mixed in, it's going to be absolutely delicious. Beautiful, beautiful. I won't be trimming that piece off because it's going to dry up. I'm going to keep my stocky tub on the other side of me. Let's see if we can find another one like that, shall we? Maybe this one isn't as yellow as that one, but it is as fatty. Looks good. Let's check it out. Yeah, it's not as yellow, but nice fat on it. Some beautiful fat. I like to just clean my blade up. So here, let's use our honing blade. So, let's just trim this fat off here. Get in, go all the way down. I'm not going to be too pedantic, shall I say. You know I repeat myself every video. Pedantic is my word. Anal is the other word. Means the same thing. So, let's get this lime off there. The idea is to get yourself your knife underneath that. Get a hold of it. Try and keep hold of it. And go underneath. Watch your fingers. Pull and cut at the same time. You can get 99% of it. Some silver sides from some suppliers will have it cut off already, as you've seen in the past. Seems my Irish, this is Irish beef, by the way. I sometimes have Isle of Man beef. Did not get any of that this week. Got the Irish. Irish. Like a bit of Irish. So, all I'm doing is separating the two roasts again. Much smaller roast, this one. I have got some other bigger ones. Let's move this bottom round, as we call it, to the side. Get rid of that sinew on the side here. Clearly I've done this a couple of times. Several times, maybe. So here, we've got some nice hard fat. They've left a little bit of hair on there, so that's going to come off straight away. So another reason I like to rinse them off when they come out the bags, because sometimes they leave a couple of black hairs on there, depending on the color of the cow or steer or whatever they've actually processed. I don't want to take too much of this off, actually, because it all looks quite nice. There was a little bit of slippery stuff there. I'm going to turn this back onto its back. I'm going back to my saboteur on this one. I'm just going to alternate between the two blades. This one's nice and sharp as well, because I just did it. Oh, that's going to fall off into the rubbish. So, nice straight edge. you can, and I will prove this right now, leave it on its back with the fatty side down, and you can still slice through it. Just means when you get down the bottom, you got to go through that fat, which is a little harder than just normal meat. You see the marbling in this meat is spot on as well. It's got some lovely marbling in there. If you're a meat connoisseur, this is your roast. We're going to have some beautiful tasting biltong. We'll go in this evening. Today is what, Friday? Be ready Sunday evening. Might leave you live as I go. I'm going to spice some of this straight away so you can see the entire process. Apart from the drying and then the processing after that, which is pretty simple and standard anyway. So, let's... Don't like when it moves. I do not want the meat to move. I am going one after the other and just doing that last little bit there. I'll still get dried. This should all be separate now. If I flip that over, boom, that is all sliced and ready to go into the dryer. Let's spread that out a bit to show you some really nice marbling in here. You can see the marbling. That's going to make it extra tasty. That's probably 4 or 5 kilos there. Here we have, someone seems to have hacked it into the side here. See, if you do get an odd, like a black piece like that, where the blood is just congealed a bit, cut it out. You don't want it, cut it out. Obviously, I like a bit of fat, so these two are lean enough for stokkies. So, they get cut to thin strips. Stokkies. Not as lean as the few pieces I got off the last roast. So, flick this back over. Trying to keep this all together. Obviously, the warmer the meat gets, the harder it is to handle. See, somebody sliced into this and made it very awkward for me. But that's really nice. It's nice, nice, nice. I've just spotted another tiniest little hair. Where'd he go? Yeah, I got him. I hate when they don't pack it properly. I'm gonna rinse that whole piece because I lost the little one. Buggers. Right, we're gonna have two relatively thick pieces here. Nice fat on there. Very nice. Always look for foreign bits or things that aren't meant to be in your meat. Obviously, you don't want to be picking stuff out your teeth, do you? I got one more. Monstrous, monstrous. Look at the size of this bugger. That is a big, big, big boy. Oh my goodness. For someone with backache like myself, not the greatest I've got two left. This is second to last. It's really nice yellow fat from this one. Okay. That's a beast. As always, we start, nearly caught my finger there. We start on the underside and we get rid of all this slippery stuff. Anything obvious, it's coming off. I wonder if Becky's watching. You watching, Bex? She likes watching the meat. There's a lot of slippery stuff down here. That is pretty gross. And now you know why I cut it off, because why would I want to give that to my customers? I want them to taste the best, and you can't get the best with the worst in there. A friend of mine walked past a South African shop 2 days ago, said he saw biltong for 94, is it 95 a kilo? I thought that's ridiculous. Some people are taking liberties. That is properly taking the piss. I would never dream of going as high as that. But then again, in London, maybe they have the overheads. Yes, you notice I've switched back to my new knife. I do like it. Works well. Slicing well. It's a nice weight. Feels good in my hand. If you'd like the link, let me know. Readily available on Amazon. It's a Nego classic line. You can search it. Don't think overly expensive. Can't remember. But I sent the link as an idea for someone for my Christmas and they bought it for me. So thank you, Al and Bex. Right. We are now splitting the two roasts. Trying to get to the bottom of this, there's a bit of meat here. Should actually cut that off because that will be dried for biltong. I want the sinew underneath, you see. Should be using my filleting knife, so let's do that. I haven't actually taken a lot of fat off these today. Usually my fat tub is full and it's not even half. It's good. Less waste, less money thrown away as well. Seems a lot of suppliers seem intent on raising their prices just to get rich quick, and I'm not gonna join them. I'd rather give quality at a reasonable price. My prices are still very competitive, I think. May need to review in April, but see how we go. Right. Split that now. Again, we want the sinew off the side. Just taking a little bit of meat off with that, that's fine. Still a little bit of slimy stuff here. You can see a major artery here. It'll get sliced and dried. So I'm gonna turn this. You can see the nice yellow fat here. The bottom is very slippy and hanging off, so I'm gonna trim some of that off. I know that is sacrilege. If I don't take it off now, it comes off in the tumbler when I am spicing. So the very loose stuff comes off. That's all good now. There's a little bit of dark stuff there. It's fine. Let us begin. I'm going to turn it on its back. And once again, we just go straight in. Make sure you've gone all the way through. Be very careful with your knife. Accidents are avoidable. I'm going to make some really nice long pieces here. Beautiful, beautiful. Look at that. Absolutely delish. I want to flick it on its side. I want a few lean bits off this roast. Makes the slices a little more uniform. Let's do another one more. Before we continue with that one, see these lean bits? Slice, slice, slice. That's why stokkies are also quite expensive. You lose 60-70% of your weight. Really, with biltong, you're losing nearly 50% anyway. With the really dry stuff, obviously, also 60-70%. Don't worry about the odd little thicker piece. Still dry as dry. Even these odd shaped, I say that, I'm putting that straight in the biltong pile. Not worth cutting those as stokkies. Let's do it this way now. If you get a little piece come off, just move it. I'm not gonna go all the way through it this time. Just gonna follow through. We're using the new knife. Whoa, going a bit cockeye there. A bit squonky. I like squonk. It's a nice word. Right, nicely does it. I have almost gone through with that one. Just simply run your fingers in between each slice. Make sure you've gone through. Where you haven't, take your end of your blade and just go through. Try not to create too many flaps in the skin. If you're in a hot country where there may be flies, that's where they lay their eggs. Look at that. Absolutely beautiful, beautiful. Bottom round now. Let's take the bottom off. The bottom off the bottom. I'm just cutting some thinner pieces here because I want enough to be able to do some some stokkies as well. That piece I'm going straight down the middle. I usually do this afterwards, but for your benefit, I'm doing it as we do them. This for chilli bites or original bites. Don't mind a little bit of fat, but if I do see a piece I can take off, I will take it off. Because traditionally, stokkies would be very lean. Nice. Rock and roll. Right, we've got this nice piece now. Let's just go straight down. Beautiful fat on this. Very nice. It's like cutting into a moist cake. Very moist. Sorry if you are offended by that word. Some people do not like it. Right. Pretty much gone through those. You can see that is really, really good. So I'm going to have quite a bit of fatty. And for my next and last roast, I'm going to try and get quite a bit of lean off this one. Still has some nice fat on it, so I may still try and keep that. It's nowhere near as what the other ones have been done. So, it will get trimmed up as much as I can. Let's just clean up the blades a bit. Hold your horses. You can see it's not a very big roast. Let's just use our honing. All I'm doing is running my blades on them just a bit, just to clean the edge up of the blade. I'm still learning how to do that. Right, let's start with the very thin, as always, filleting blade. Got a bit of meat here. Let's keep that piece. Why not? Waste not, what not. So, try to be very careful when you are trimming. Very easy to prick yourself. It's easy to slice into your glove if you are wearing them. Not mandatory, it's not essential. As long as your hands are very clean, you are good to go. Right, so gone in just underneath that. If anybody's wondering, yes, I gave up on the damn fat trimmer, but look how nicely that came off. Yes, I missed half of it, but and this bit comes off with a bit of meat. Try to get most of it off. As I've said before, this is the tough stuff. Should try and dry it one day for the dogs to chew on. Eat. just don't know. Right. So this is the seam here. Try and get in there. If you can split it apart, do that. Try and follow the seam down so that you can get to this bit here. Take that edge off. Like I said, I'm trying to get most of this as lean as possible now, so I will be quite pedantic with this one. So now I've split that one. Let's just clean up this edge. Still a bit of fat on here. I want it all gone. I want most of it gone. I'm trying to get in here to get this bit of tendon here. We've got a bit of fat on the end here. It's going to come off with some what we're going to use. We're going to use the big blade. Just prove to you that you can do this with pretty much any knife. Now don't curse me for taking this fat off. I've got a lot of fatty biltong in stock, so don't actually need any more fatty. Well, I might do by the end of the week, but slowly and surely we take off that top layer. So this is very thin stuff anyway. If you're not comfortable cutting one way, cut, turn your meat, turn it wherever you need it. You can see what I'm doing here. I'm pulling on the fat, just picking up a bit of meat there. That's pretty much taken it all off. It's good. Let's get that bit off there. Careful when you're cutting towards yourself. You do not want to give yourself a vasectomy. So I'm obviously being quite take that off with a bit of fat. See that little piece? Go into the biltong pile. As will this piece here, because there'll be some fat there. So let's just go straight in here. These very short pieces I don't bother with to make stokkies, because otherwise you're just filling your whole machine up for the sake of a kg or something. It's really not worth. So it become lean biltong. Same as this bit here now. There's a little bit of fat here. So it is sent to the biltong pile. At this point you can turn it over if you need to. You see I went at an angle there, so I've now straightened that up. Try not to force your way through. See, I've got quite a long strip here. That bit will come off. So will that. That'll be a stokkie. I can do this as I slice. Don't be afraid to let the odd piece be a little bit thicker. It's fine. Try not to go too thin. You want a bit of meat on there. Now you can see these, it's got a little bit of fat in the meat, but when you're doing the stokkies or the chilli bites, it'll be just an extra tasty piece, I believe. Now this piece is going to be a little bit thin. Here we go. You want to leave it thick enough so that you can put a biltong hook through it. I don't drape mine, I don't use any separate machines or anything. It goes into the same biltong dryer and is hung on a hook, just like the biltong. The only thing I go over with is the drill horse. I go over my rails. They don't need to be hung on a hook. See this one? There's a bit of fat on there. I'll keep that as biltong. That goes into stokkies. What we're going to do with this one, there's a bit of nice fat on there. I'm just going to take that whole top off. See? Bit of fat. Slice that in half. Bob's your auntie. Here, I want to trim this bit off. I want it nice and lean. I am being quite pedantic, as I said. Let's do it properly. If you're going to do a job, do it properly. There's my advice. This coming from an African, my goodness me. Bodged so many flipping jobs, it's unreal. If you can get something working through a bodge, then you do that too. All right, let's create us an edge here. As soon as I've got a flat edge, turn it over. You can see little bits of fat on there. I want those off, actually. Looks a bit too sinewy, that bit. We're going to go straight in and down, in, down. I can tell you that this knife is flippin' awesome. It's like a Swiss cracker. Let's get three bits out of this one. So obviously we're cutting these thin stripes. Thin strips. For stokkies, chilli bites, and original bites. I did do garlic bites at one point, but didn't really take off. Garlic isn't everybody's liking, eh? Got a couple of thicker pieces there. This piece straight down the middle. I would like to weigh that tub now because I believe we've probably got enough in there to do just a few kilos of chilli bites. We'll do some more next week if I have to. Rinse the hands off. Right, what is the next step, you say? I'm going to take you off. Woo! You still there? How's it, how's it? Woo! Only got two people watching me. What's going on? Right, let's put this in. I don't know that I can turn the camera. I don't think you can. You cannot turn your camera while you're recording. Anyway, I am going to say Happy New Year. Cheers. And keep safe. I hope you all have an awesome 2021. Tune in again next time. to see some nice silver sides being sliced. I am now going to weigh this out, spice it, and then pop it into the fridge for several hours while it marinates. And then I will be hanging it later, and it'll be ready Sunday evening. So I'm going to say cheers. Cheers, guys. Keep safe.